The toy town of Karnataka, Channapatna, is located in the southwest of Bangalore along the Bangalore-Mysore Highway. This town is famous for its handmade wooden toys and lacquerware from the time of Tipu Sultan. Channapatna toys are traditionally made of Raitya Tinctoria trees, or as locals call it, Ale Mara. What makes these toys unique is these toys are colored with safe natural dyes. These toys are manufactured in traditional or advanced small-scale industries. Other than the private factories, many people have smaller workshops in their home itself. While many people work on motorized lathes, there are a few using manual hand-driven lathes to make small parts. Maya Organic is a livelihood development initiative that helps micro-entrepreneurs and aims to create wealth and build capabilities of poor informal sector workers and their families. Maya Organic also has training programs before employing anybody into their organization. There are 40 employees who work in-house and other 60 employees who work from their respective homes as they're equipped with local toy making machines. The employees make a sum of 10,000 rupees every month depending on their experience. Majority of the employees here are women. Although they initially faced objections from their orthodox family members, they have now become more liberal in allowing them work. The employees are content with their job. The only problem they face is breathing issues due to dust which is created from making of wooden toys. Channapatna toys have been more than playthings for the many girls growing up in the town, offering them a means of livelihood and empowerment at the factory. Veerabhadra was sitting in a quiet corner and was working on lacquer as his sweat rolled down his forehead. He didn't have any complaints about working in high temperatures as this was the only means of extra income. Veerabhadra, who has been working with lacquer for above 20 years now in Maya Organic, earns around 150 rupees a day and works for about 2 days a month. On the rest of the days, he makes handmade beads at home and earns around 100 rupees a day.
We import these from Gujarat. It costs about 600 rupees per kilo. We melt this by heating, and after a few hours, it turns out to be like this. I cycle and come to this place. The money that we get is not sufficient, which is why I don't want my sons to do the same. Since I am uneducated, I can do nothing but continue this as my profession.
2 kilometers away from Maya Organic is a village called Neelasandra, where we saw almost everyone being occupied with making beads at their respective homes. The small ones are sold at 50 paisa per bead and the big ones 1 rupee. In Kalanagar, most of them are entrepreneurs themselves. In Mushtaq Ahmed's case, it's more of a family business.
I'm very satisfied with my job, but I don't want my children to take this up. We have been doing this since 5 generations now.
China-made lookalikes are entering the Delhi and Bangalore markets, which are priced at less than half of the original. They're obviously a steal for unsuspecting toy lovers. We hope that the product which is coming out from the massive efforts of the producers, which is a means of livelihood for many, does not face such kind of problems due to fake products.